Praise the Lord, my dear friends. Welcome to another edition of Times of Refreshing. It is such a great joy and honor for me to come and share God's word with all of you. I'm going to be sharing an important message today that has the potential to change your life. I've seen hundreds of lives changed as a result of the message that you're about to hear. Can you stop God from blessing you? Can you limit the power of God in your life? Listen to this message and you will find out how some of you are unintentionally stopping God from blessing you. Please feel free to share this message and invite your family and friends to listen to this message as well, as their lives will be transformed. God bless you as you listen to this message. Praise the Lord, my dear friends. Thank you for tuning in today. My prayer for you today is that you'll be greatly blessed and your life will be transformed as a result of the message that you're about to hear. And I know that the message that I'm about to share has the potential to change your life radically. So I pray that and I plead with you that you stay tuned all throughout this program and ask God to change your life as you listen to this word. I want to talk to you today about the power of your words. The words that you speak today will determine your future tomorrow. The words that you speak today can change your destiny. Do you realize that even though God is almighty, all-powerful God, you can limit the power of God in your life? You can stop God from blessing you. You may ask, how is that possible? How is it possible that I can stop God from blessing me in my life? And I've seen hundreds of people where they missed out on the greatest blessings of God because they limited the power of God in their life. Bible says in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, death and life are under the power of tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit. In other words, death and life are under the authority of the tongue or the words that we speak. And whatever you love, you will eat its fruit. Well, the choice is yours. The fruit is ready. But what kind of fruit are you reaping? What kind of fruit are you plucking out? Many people unknowingly are reaping or eating the fruit of death or curses or bondages. And I pray that this message that I'm sharing today will radically change your life and your family's life. Well, words are like seeds. You can't expect to put down or sow apple seed and get orange out of it. No. In order for you to get apples, you gotta put apple seeds. Same thing with the words that we speak as well. Well, you cannot speak the words of negativity or depression or curses and expect good things to happen in your life. Many people missed out on the blessings of God because of the words, the negative words that they have spoken. Instead of speaking the negative words like, I am not going to get better, I am going to be sick, my mother was sick, I'm going to be sick, my father was sick, I'm going to be sick. All throughout my family, everybody had financial problem. I'm going to have financial problem. All throughout my generation, I had this problem. So I'm going to have this problem as well. Well, you can stand against it. You can stop it by speaking positive words, words of God into your life. Bible says that whatever you love, you will eat the fruit of it. But everything is under your power, under your control. You can limit the power of God. Psalms 78 verse 41 says, the children of Israel limited the power of God. How can you limit the power? So what kind of seed you are planting is important for you to find out. Examine your own life. Think about it. And see what kind of words that you have spoken in your past. What kind of seed you have been sowing. We need to choose our words carefully. Do not miss out on the blessings of God because of the words that you have spoken. It's time to speak the words of life. It's time to speak the words of blessing in your life. Even if you're sick, say, my God will restore my health. Even if you're financially struggling, you say, when I come in, I will be blessed. When I go out, I'll be blessed. Speak the words of promises in your life, and you will eat its fruit. Many people unintentionally spoke the words of death, and so all kinds of problems in their life. And I know people like that. I know people who have been going through generation after generation after generation of problems. I know families from generational times when grandparents, parents, and themselves went through all kinds of divorces, and it has been going on for generations. And the same thing with sickness. It has been going on for generation after generations after generation, and they keep saying, I'm going to have this problem as well. I am going to be sick as well. But you can stop all those problems in your life by speaking life into your situation. Bible says that negative words produces negative things. You cannot expect to have a positive life but at the same time speaking negative things. No. If you want to have positive things in your life, then you must speak positive things. I can see and I can hear somebody's word and tell you whether you will experience the blessings of God by the words that you are speaking. I mean, I speak to hundreds of people, and many people say, I'm not going to be good. I'm not going to be blessed. My family is already going through problems, and I will continue to go through problems. My children are not going to be right. I can tell you, whatever you say, you are prophesying. Whatever you say, you become. You are who you are because of the words that you have been speaking in your life. Galatians 6 verse 7 says, whatever a man sows, he reaps. What are you sowing? What are you sowing today? You are reaping whatever you are sowing. Like I mentioned, you can't expect to sow an apple seed and get orange out of it. No. Whatever you are saying, whatever you are sowing, you will reap. In order for you to have good fruits in your life, you must make a choice. Death or life. If you want to experience life to its fullness, if you want to experience the blessings of God in your life, then you need to speak the words of blessings. You need to say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God will restore my health. When I go out, I will be blessed. When I come in, I will be blessed. I am going to lend to many nations and I will not have to borrow. In the city, I will be blessed. My children will be blessed. Proverbs chapter 12 verse 14, it says like this, from the fruit of his words, a man shall be satisfied with good. Listen to this word again. From the fruit of his words. Words are like fruits. And whatever words that you are speaking, you will enjoy its fruit. So that's important to understand that what you speak is what going to happen in your life. What are you saying today? Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. Maybe you're weak today. Maybe you're going through all kinds of circumstances and difficulties. But Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. You need to be convinced in your heart that the power of the Almighty God is deposited in your life. Many times we are not convinced that the presence of God is with us. You're not listening to the word that says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. As a result of it, because you do not believe it, you are speaking words of curses in your life. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 2, it says that you are snared by the words of your mouth. In other words, you are trapped by the words of your mouth. You don't need other people to put witchcraft against you. All you need to do is just speak the words of bondages and curses, and you are trapped. And many of you are trapped because of the words that you have spoken. You need to ask God for forgiveness today and make a decision that you will never say anything that produces death, produces curses, produces poverty, produces sickness in your life. Malachi chapter 3 verse 16, he says, then those who feared the Lord spoke to one another, and the Lord listened and heard them. God is listening. What is God listening to? God is listening to the words that you are speaking. Can you imagine? God is listening to your words, and the words that you are saying, that's what God and God's angel is acting upon. That's why I mentioned earlier that you can stop the blessings of God in your life by the words that you are speaking. What are you using your words and tongue for? God has given you a powerful instrument, powerful organ, powerful weapon. And how are you using that weapon? Listen to this in James chapter 3, verse 9. It says, We bless our God and the Father. We bless, we praise God with our mouth. We lift up the name of God with our mouth. We magnify the name of God with our mouth. But then it says, and with it we curse men who have been made in the image of God. Are you praising God with the mouth and at the same time cursing other people and yourself with the same mouth? James says, run away from it. Flee from it. Do not use the same tongue and words to curse yourself unknowingly. See, Holy Spirit wants you to listen to this message so your life can be radically changed. You will have a good future. There is a limit to what God can do in your life because of the words that you speak. God has ordained laws in this world, in spiritual world and earthly realm as well. For example, if I throw something up there, it will come down. Why? Because it's a law of gravity. That's what God orchestrated. God established that law. It doesn't matter who's throwing it. The wicked can throw it, or godly people can throw it. It doesn't matter who you are. The same thing will happen. If you throw something, it will come down. In spiritual world, this law is established as well, that the death and life was under the power of your word. That's a spiritual law. What you are saying today can change your destiny, and it will change your destiny. Use the tongue to speak the favor of God in your life. Use the tongue to speak healing and blessing and prosperity and peace and joy in your life. Whatever you speak, you will eat the fruit of it, Bible says. Job chapter 22, verse 22, verse 28 and 29, when you study it carefully, it says like that, thou shalt decree a thing and it shall be established unto thee. I hope and pray you get this word very deep in your heart. Thou shalt decree a thing. The word decree is a royal word. The kings decree. Ordinary citizens do not decree. The kings decree. The people with authority make a declaration or decrees. Bible says you will decree a thing. What are you decreeing? What are you declaring? And it will be established unto you. In other words, what you are decreeing, it will be established in your life. So it's important that you decree the power of God in your life. You can't talk defeat and expect victory in your life. It does not happen. I don't care who you are. I don't care whether you are a saint of God or anybody. It does not matter. If you are proclaiming defeat, if you are speaking the words of defeat, you will not have victory in your life. If you're always saying, well, problems are everywhere, this person is against me, that person is against me, nothing will change in your life. But if you say, my God is with me, God will give me victory, I will be greatly blessed, my children will be greatly blessed, then I will tell you that you will be greatly blessed because of the words that you are speaking. I mentioned to you that when you speak the word of God, Lord is listening. God is listening and God is hearing what you are saying. Psalms 103 verse 20, it says, bless the Lord, you his angels, who excels in strength, who do his word, heeding the voice of his word. In other words, angels are ministering angels to those who are saved. But one of the ministry of the angels of God is when you proclaim the words, the angels of God takes your word and executes it. When you are speaking the word of God, angels executes it. The words that you are speaking, angels are executing it. So the question today is, the angels in your life, what are they executing? What are they executing in your life? It's very important that you prophesy rather than curse your life. The words that we speak is a prophecy in your life. You don't need a prophet to come and speak to you. You need to prophesy in your own life, say, I am blessed. You need to prophesy and say, I am going to have a good future. You need to prophesy in your life that says, my valley will be a mountain. I will be financially blessed. My children will be blessed. That's what you need to prophesy. Many people, many parents unknowingly are cursing the children with the words that they are speaking. I want you to make a U-turn, turn around. Maybe you did it unintentionally. Maybe you did it without knowing this truth. And that is why this word message is very important. I pray that you will share with your friends and your family. Prophesy the blessings of God in your life. See, in the Old Testament, in the book of Numbers chapter 13, God told Moses, select one person from each tribe and let them go out and see the land of Canaan. Now remember, God already promised them that God will take them to the land of Canaan. That's why God brought the people of Israel from the land of Egypt through this journey. People of Israel saw the miracles of God every single day. They saw Pharaoh being defeated and crushed. From the small house of Egypt to the palace of Egypt, they saw the hand of God move. And these the same people saw the greatest sea, Dead Sea, Red Sea, divided into two. They saw the miracles of God every single day. They saw heavenly manna, the food manna, heaven's angels' food, come down every single morning. They had the best food. And they saw water gushing out of the rock. They saw meat, the quail, every single evening. God provided them supernaturally. The presence of God was with them every single day. Can you imagine? They saw God's presence. Pillar of cloud by day, pillar of fire by night. They were traveling in the wilderness, so they needed a cooling. God provided them cooling. When they needed light, the pillar of fire gave them light. Every single day, they saw the miracles of God. But yet, when God asked them to go see the land of Canaan, what did they do? They forgot what God has done in their life. They went to see the land. They saw giants. They saw children of Anak. And they said, we are like grasshoppers in front of them. They said, we cannot conquer it. They said, it's impossible for us. They said, no, not even God can help us. That's what essentially they were saying. They were seeing God small and these giants and their problem was much bigger than God was. They spoke the words of negative consequences. They spoke words of failure. They spoke the words of unbelief and unfaithfulness. What happened? Only two people entered the land of Canaan, Joshua and Caleb. The only two people who said, we can do it. 12 people saw the same thing. All 12 people saw the giants. All 12 people saw the land. But two people did not speak any negative words. They said, we can. God is with us. We can conquer the land. God told us we will. Therefore, we are going to. I want to tell you today, the 10 people and their majority, except two, every single one of them, failed because of the negative words that they spoke. Only two people entered the promised land because they spoke the words of belief, faith, victory. Today, as you listen to this message, make a decision to speak the words of victory. Don't look at the circumstances. Don't look at what is happening around you. Yes, there is people dying all over us. People are struggling. Financial problems, economic problems, problems everywhere. But what you need to do is speak the words of victory in your life because God of victory is with you. Do not forget that fact that God of victory is in your life. This God who promised you will keep his word. So I want to leave you with this thought. Words are trapped. So don't trap yourself by speaking negative things. Your destiny is determined by the words that you speak. Words that you speak today will determine your future. So speak the words of victory. Death and life are under the power of tongue. Those who love it will eat its fruit. What kind of fruit are you eating? It all depends on what you are saying. So I pray today that your life will be radically changed. I speak to many of you, and I know the problems some of you are going through. But in spite of all the problems that you are facing, keep proclaiming victory. Keep proclaiming deliverance. Keep proclaiming goodness of God. Just say, goodness of God, goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. I will have a long life. If I don't believe, David said, I will see the goodness of God in the land of the living. In other words, woe to me if I don't believe that I see goodness of God in the land of the living. In other words, as long as I live, I will see the goodness of God. Yes, David was being attacked from every side. Saul was attacking him. The whole army of Israel, can you imagine, was trying to get him. A whole army against one person. But David said, if I don't believe that I see goodness of God in the land of the living, woe to me. Therefore, I will see goodness of God. I will see the blessings of God. I will have victory. You will have victory, my friend. Keep speaking victory in your life and over your family and over your children. You will see goodness of God. You will see the mercy of God. Because our God is our Heavenly Father. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. No matter what happens in your life, He's always with you. God is God, not the God of failure. God is God of victory. That God will give you victory when you trust Him with all your heart. But the key is speaking the words of victory in your life. Death and life are under the power of your words. So choose life today. May God bless you as you listen to this message and ponder this message.
I hope and pray that you have been greatly blessed by the message that you have heard. If you have any prayer requests, please call the prayer line. The numbers are on the screen. If you would like to send me a message, my number is on the screen as well. God bless you. I want to come to an agreement with you and ask God to heal you, to bless you. The Bible says, if two of you agree on it concerning anything, it will be done. So let's agree that God will bless you. Let us pray. Father, I pray for my dear friend who watches this program. Whatever problems that they are going through right now, I pray that you would touch them in Jesus' name, the name that is above every name. I pray for those who are sick in their body. Lord, your word says, with your stripes, we are healed. We are praying right now for their healing according to your promise, according to your word. In Jesus' name, be healed. I pray for those who are going through family problems. Lord, you are the Prince of Peace. I pray that you would touch them and rebuke every spirit of division, every attack of the enemy in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for those who are financially struggling. Lord, I pray that you would bless them, for you are the provider. You are the Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, Lord God, for answering all our prayers. I bless each and everyone who listen to this program. Let your name be glorified and exalted. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Well, God bless you until I see you next week. May God's presence be with you.